One of my laboratory's major focuses is on genes that influence athletic performance. And one particular gene is alpha-actinin 3 that's been fondly dubbed the gene for speed. Now, many years ago, I started looking at alpha-actinin 3 as a potential disease gene in muscular dystrophies. And in studying the gene, which is a recipe for a protein, I found that there was a mistake or a variation in the gene that caused alpha-actinin 3 to be completely deficient in skeletal muscle. But it wasn't associated with muscle disease, because what we found is that 1 in 5 people in the general population are deficient in alpha-actinin 3. Rather than pursuing it in muscle disease, we actually thought we'd go to look and see if it influenced human muscle performance and studied the other end of the spectrum, which is the elite athlete. So we collaborated with the Australian Institute of Sport to study elite athletes, so those that have represented Australia at the Olympics and international competitions. And what we found was that whether or not you have alpha-actinin 3 really influences whether you're going to be better as a specialist sprint athlete or a specialist endurance athlete. I must say it's important to know the genetic variations, but there are probably hundreds of genes that influence overall athletic performance. I think alpha-actinin 3 and how it's expressed could influence your choice as to whether to specialise in sprint or endurance track events, for example. But really, it's the athlete is the whole package. It's a combination of environment, genetics, and mental attitude. I think what will happen in the future is that we'll identify a whole smorgasbord of genes that have different influence on genetic performance. And it's going to be the combinations of different genetic traits that are important. But we're not at that stage yet. A single gene does not make a difference. Because we know that the presence or absence of alpha-actinin 3 influences muscle performance in elite athletes, our question was, is it influencing muscle disease at the other end of the spectrum? And our studies in mice and humans have shown that this is the case. Whether or not you have alpha-actinin 3 influences disease severity. And now we understand that the molecular mechanisms involved, we can start to harness that in terms of directing future therapies.